There have been unprecedented advances in medical research in the last few decades, but it takes too long to get from these discoveries to health benefits. In the CTSA program, over 50 medical research institutions work together to accelerate that process. No single institution could do this alone. We want to make sure that we don't reinvent the wheel at each place, but that we really leverage each other's tools, resources, and work. The program is really about innovation. It's about improving processes, looking for opportunities to make a difference that's not just incremental, but oftentimes really transformative. Examples of what the CTSA program is doing to accelerate the process from discovery to health benefit are streamlining the startup of a clinical trial. And it can often take a year or longer to get a trial off the ground. One factor in that is the review by an institutional review board. And I remember when I was in academia, I wanted to start a trial for patients with Lou Gehrig's disease. And it took so long to get the trial started that every time the patient came back to clinic asking me about it, I had to say, we're not quite ready yet. And then finally, when we were able to open the trial, the patient was too sick to participate, and that was just wrong. And I thought, you know, we need to do something about that. And the CTSA program is in a unique position to do that because we have this large network, so they can now rely on each other's institutional review board. Another example of how the CTSA program improves the process of implementing multi-site trials. One of the barriers often is getting enough people to participate in trials. So a lot of trials, whether they're done by industry or by the NIH, have to go abroad and recruit patients at many of our CTSA hubs, as we call them, these medical research centers. We have now somebody on the ground whose job it is to really focus on how to get participants connected to trial opportunities. And we also have an initiative that tries to connect different medical centers through the electronic health record to figure out where patients are who potentially meet the entry criteria for the trial, so they can very quickly identify where the best places are to invite people to participate. And we have already a successful pilot study where they were able to show that that can be done quickly. Imagine a world where you had like a clinical trial that could enroll patients in 2 weeks. So you could just in a very rapid time frame, you know, get from a question to an answer and then ultimately help patients. The CTSA program has a large component of training pre-doctoral and postdoctoral fellows, young investigators, and giving them the skills needed for translating discoveries into health benefits. Another important skill in this context is team science, because it is no longer a world in which one investigator can work on his or her own in the laboratory, but it's a world where people with very different skill sets have to work together in teams. The unique part of the CTSA program is that it can really help innovate across all spectrum of research. It's not focused on a particular set of diseases. Rather, it tries to provide tools and innovations that could benefit all kinds of diseases and populations. The NIH is all about improving health through research. I think there is a unique role for the CTSA program in accelerating translation that will help everybody in all projects at the NIH.